There's a better look at where my bull fell off now that the fog's cleared. We came down to have a look for Aaron's bull, and we can only find a couple of tiny bits of blood, and it's just turned to custard. And as far as my bull was concerned, that's where he was bedded. He dropped right there on that spur, and then 20 seconds later kicked off, and we heard a big thump quite a few seconds later, and there's no way we're going down there. Aaron's already had one mishap. He slipped on this tussock. You guys probably know, over the winter time when the snow's here, it lays all the tussock downhill, almost like a current in a river. And when the snow melts, all the tussock's facing downhill, and it's as slippery as buggery. Aaron slipped and hit 60 miles an hour in about 1 second. Luckily, there was a shingle slide, 10 or 15 metres below him, so he managed to pull up, but he was a bit shaken. Man, bad luck. It was a successful mission. We managed to find a roundabout route through those two gorges over to this main ridge that we wanted to look at. We put down a GPS track log in case we have to come back here in the dark. It'd be a bit of a nightmare without some sort of route to follow. So yeah, we'll probably come back over here in the next couple of days and put in a full day right to the top of this ridge here. Yeah, good. Oh, there we were, having a good old glassing session. You guessed it, bloody fog.
Yeah, it's nice gully though, eh? Nice country.
Well, it is when you can see it.
Yeah, it was nice when we got here. We saw a chamois down here on a slip close to the creek, and a tahr up high on one of the faces, but it was just getting on to the right hour to start hopefully seeing a few animals pop out, and old mates were all back in. Yeah. Reckon he's probably teaching us a lesson for getting up early or late this morning. Oh, I got up early, but Matt slept in, so yeah. I couldn't go and do anything.
Yeah, right.
I couldn't get him out of bed. Lazy bastard.
A lot of you guys would know what it's like in the fog. You get bored pretty quick. I remember reading in a book years ago, I can't remember what book, but about this musterers, high country musterers back in the day, when they were bored up on the hill, they'd be standing up on some high ridge somewhere. They'd get these mountain flax stems and put a wee notch in there, like that. Then walk over the old flax bush, select a nice dart looking specimen, trim it back to an aerodynamic shape, and then if you can zoom in here, Aaron, just get a sliver down the backbone. Is it focusing? Whoops, that didn't work. Strip that down about there.
come back to the stamp, tie that round there. This is making me look very uncoordinated. Just slip that in that groove there. What you ended up with is that there. So to have a bit of fun, these old musters apparently used to stand up on these ridges and there'd be sheep way in the gullies below them, hundreds of metres down. And you watch what happens when I biff this. If you're standing on a ridge, they go hundreds and hundreds of metres. Right?
Yeah.
You get the idea anyway. If you select a very aerodynamic one and get a good stout stem, tie your knot properly, and honestly, they go for hundreds of meters. It's awesome fun. There you go, fellas. Get bored in the fog one day. We tip for you.
Matt Winter, dart throwing, take two.
Yeah, I think I've selected a much better dart. It's more aerodynamic. With good weightage up the front and a much, much more solid knot.
Very good. Take two.
This one is going to disappear into the fog. I'm even going to get a running start. That went good. Awesome.
Okay. Aaron couldn't help himself, he had to get in on the fun. No pressure.
I've been watching Matt closely, and as you probably saw in his last one, the secret is the follow through. So my focus for this is going to be my follow through. So here we go.
As you were.
And I'm going to have a run up as well.
Run up.
Yeah.
It's key.
Righto. Run up.
It made all the difference.
We reckon.
Absolutely.
I rolled down the hill. Getting too old for that shit.
Kevin the Kia. Bugger me.
We were talking earlier on about how dangerous this kind of rolly tussocky country is, and mentioned those holes. Here's an example. Aaron's standing in there, believe it or not, and it's just, you wouldn't even know it's there. It's just surrounded by tussock.
Covered by tussocks, hey? Just
step straight
into it.
Imagine grovelling your way down here in the dark and falling into that.
Yeah. This should be a bloody neck breaker, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Man.
Gotta love it when you wake up to views like that. Beautiful.
What's happening this morning?
Yeah, we've got morning day four. So I've come back round to these faces that we came to 2 days ago. We're going to split up actually. I'm going to carry up. I wouldn't mind just trying to get to the top range. Just to say that I've done it. And
he's a bit like that. Once on every trip that we have, Aaron has to go to the tallest mountain in the area.
Yeah.
He can't help himself.
Yeah.
I'm going to stay low and stooge around here, look for a Sammy.
Matt will probably see heaps and I'll probably see nothing, but... Oh.
You have the satisfaction of saying you get to the top, though.
Oh. You'll probably get something, though. But anyway, I've got my camera, so I'll try and take some footage as well when I get up there. And yeah, maybe bump into some tar again. Be good.
Oh, gee.
Weather looks right, eh?
Yeah.
Pea soup hasn't come in yet, so well, it's working its way up the gully here now. But
we're guessing that stuff underneath us might lift up.
Seems to be the pattern, though, eh? If you sit and wait it out, it breaks up after a while, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And you get, so it's a matter of... I'll just keep climbing. Yeah.
Oh, gee.
See you on the way.
I've just spent about, I don't know, 3 or 4 hours in the fog again. And it's been clear now for about an hour and I haven't seen anything yet. Been slowly waking my way down the ridge here and have a look over there, and it looks like an old hut. Remains of an old hut there. I wonder what the story is behind that. My curiosity got the better of me. I just had to come over here and have a look at this old hut. Funny, well, it's not a funny place. It's parked up on a wee spur out in the middle of nowhere. And on my way down, found this old water pipe here. I have to do some digging when I get home and find out the story behind it. Old chimney there by the look of it. Jeez. Bit of timber there. Bit of iron for that matter. There's a fair bit of material there. It looks like a would have been quite a sizable hut. That there might be a clue. It looks like the old Forest Service orange. I'm also guessing that this flat area here was probably where it was situated, and the wind has blown it off its foundations over into there. I learnt my lesson the other day, I think it was the second day, when I got this sunburnt face, got the old hat on today. I'm not going to bother spending time down here. A real nice looking gully, but I mean, even if I saw something down there, there's no way I'd be able to get down there to stalk it, so I'll wander back up the ridge here and spend the rest of the afternoon at the top of a spur that I know I can get down. At least if something pops out there, I know I'll have a chance at it. And I've just heard from Aaron. He's way up the top of here. He said he's only about half an hour from the top of the ridge, the main range. But there's a snow, icy snowfield that he wasn't prepared to cross. So, and he's only seen two bulls today, so not many animals about. Awesome country, though. This stuff down here just screams chamois. I'm sure there's some down there, but can't justify spending time there, so we'll carry on back up the ridge. Yippee! First animal for the day. A chamois down in that creek there, just on the edge of the scrub. Centre screen. That's lifted the old spirits a bit. Spectre of the Brocken. Cool.
What do you say?
Yeah, yep. Well, in the space of one video transition, we've gone from high on a West Coast ridge to a highway lay-by in Murchison. To explain all that, we had to make a quick exit from the hut this morning, the weather that was due in about lunchtime tomorrow came in a day early, so we had to arrange a pickup this morning. So yeah, very rushed packing job and out a day early, so apologies for the abrupt ending. But just to give a bit of a recap, if you like, on what happened yesterday afternoon, which wasn't much. We split up, didn't we, early in the day?
Yeah.
And usual story, a lot of time spent in the fog and actually got rained on this time. But yeah, you went up high, didn't you?
Yep. But same as Matt. Probably about 3/4 of the way up to the top ridge, and the fog came in and then the rain came in with it. So I spent probably 2 hours cuddled up in a ball of more wet weathers, waiting it out. And sure enough, it did lift, and it turned out to be quite a nice day after that.
You're looking in here, eh? Other than the viewfinder?
No.
Yeah, look at that, not that.
Okay, you got to cut this bit out.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so...
I might not.
Yeah, but apart from that, it was a wee bit uneventful for my part. Like, it was good. I got to get up near the top, but didn't quite make it due to some snow that I couldn't get past. But other than that, didn't see any chamois, unfortunately. But I saw, in the end, five tahr that came across from quite a scrubby ridge off the gun ridge, and they fed up the face in an inaccessible place. Unfortunately, there tended to be a steeper side and a nice tusky side, and all the animals, as you would Murphy would have it, they're all on the steep, inaccessible side, so made it a wee bit difficult, but yeah.
But from where I went, Aaron went high, I went down the ridge that we split up on, and I only saw a doe and a kid for the day, but what it did afford me a better view back into the gut, the steep rocky gut where Aaron's tahr went, and I mean, we were peering off the edge into it when we were tracking.
Yeah,
we couldn't get down, but the angle I had on it later in that yesterday, I could actually see the dead animal right down in this big steep rocky chute. And I mean, even if we knew it was there when we were tracking it, there's no way we would have got down to it. So
shame, eh?
Real shame.
Yeah, I guess that's not uncommon for tahr hunting, but it's the first real time it's happened to us, isn't it?
Yeah. So. You have been pretty lucky in that respect.
Yeah, we've been lucky, I guess. So, bound to happen, but it's just a shame. Would have been nice to bring a tahr home, and yeah.
So, that's about us for the trip. We were talking on the way back drive about some spearfishing missions coming up over the summer.
Yep.
And we've got our raw trip coming up, and we're hoping to get another May tahr trip again, as long as Bugalo doesn't break his neck again.
You know, there's a bit to look forward to. Apparently the kingies are in, so the water's warming up, so they're not far away, so it'll be good. Get in the water and try and skewer one of those. And yeah, no doubt we'll do a bit of sort of overnighters in the summer too, won't we?
Yep.
In Mulga, chase some deer and that, so that'd be good. So there's a bit coming up, but
yeah.
Awesome. Good trip though, nice country.
Yeah,
just not a lot of animals, but good country, and it was good to go somewhere different and look around.
Yeah, it was new for us, so it's that's always good.
Yep. And in the time we had, we probably worked most of it anyway, hadn't we?
Yeah.
The type of country it was. Type of country it was, you could glass it pretty well. So, yeah, we'd glass most of it and, give it a good look over. So it's good. Good trip.
Righty-o. Hooroo. Say hooroo.
Hooroo. Cheers, Matty.
Yeah.
Thanks for another one, mate. See you next time.